A cheerful good morning to each and every one of you present today in the science class. Let us start with our today's class with some of the informations related to your COVID-19. Okay, so it is the same thing, repetition of what we have earlier discussed as well. Okay, the winters are approaching more and more, as well as the smog you are able to see, which were very common in Delhi. Now they are too common in Varanasi as well. Okay, as what the situation just 2 to 3 days back. Okay, apart from this, the smog and everything, it is my humble request that is this mask is not only going to prevent you or sorry protect you from this COVID-19, but the mask is also going to protect you from the harmful air pollutants which may enter into your lungs and cause various kinds of respiratory diseases. Okay, so this is going to benefit you in both the ways, that is in terms of your air pollutants as well as in terms of your COVID-19 virus as well. So before starting with this, as this is our, what I remember is this is the fourth class of this air and water. Okay, so let us quickly just go through this and let us start with our today's class. I hope all of you are having the thorough reading of the chapter as it has been told to you in the homeworks, because unless and until you are going to read the chapter, you are not able to understand this thing. And apart from this thing, please just don't be dependent on me only, because in your higher classes you only have to read the entire chapter, and the question answers will be asked from the middle of the chapters as well. And even now as well, all of you know that now the number of questions is very, very less from the middle of the chapters, but the levels you go higher up, the number of questions is going to be maximum from the middle of the chapters and very less from the exercises, or even none from the exercises as well. Okay, so without any delay, or I'm not able to get, or this is good, that is all of you are able to understand each and every part, because I'm not getting any kind of queries in the query window. Okay, so maybe either two पॉसिबिलिटीज आर देयर, जैसा कि मैं आप लोग को पहले भी बता चुका हूँ कि या तो आप लोग को सब कुछ समझ में आ रहा है या तो आप लोग को कुछ भी नहीं समझ में आ रहा है. ओके, सो इन बोथ द केसेस नथिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन विथ मी, इट इज ओनली यू हु आर गोइंग टू बी एट अ ग्रेटर लॉस. ठीक है, तो अगर आपको अपने लॉस से बचना है, सो प्लीज हैव अ थॉरो रीडिंग एंड कीप ऑन आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस, सेंटेंसेस, वर्ड्स, फ्रेजेस और एनीथिंग विच यू आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड in this chapter. Okay, as this is a very friendly chapter, very common chapter in between us, but we don't care a lot for this, because maybe we do not take it to be much more important, but this has to be a concern for this, because nowadays and the coming future is going to be have the sustainable use of resources, as well as we have to use or not pollute the air as well. If you would have gone through the newspapers as well, each and every, even today's news, yesterday's newspaper, if you would have read, so it has been told that from up to 31st, that is from 14 to 31st or 13 to 31st, Delhi NCR regions has been completely banned for your crackers. They don't have to use any one of them. Okay, so let us see what happens, and the situations are very much alarming. ठीक है, अगर अभी हम लोग नहीं सुधरेंगे तो फिर इट इज गोइंग टू कॉज अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम फॉर अस. ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दिस. अगेन वी हैव ऑल द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज योर एयर एंड वाटर. ओके ओके, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एयर वी हैव टू स्टार्ट, एंड एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड आवर दिस ऑल द फाइव लेयर्स ऑफ द एटमोसफियर. Starting with this part, that is the properties of air. So we cannot see or smell air, yet we know that it is all around us. We can feel it. How can we feel it? Okay, we can feel it moving on windy days. Air has mass and occupies space. See the activities 2 and 3. Therefore, air is also matter. Matter, as all of you know that we have discussed in our previous chapters, that is matter is anything that has space and it occupies mass as well. Okay, so air is having both the characteristics, that is it is having the mass as well as it is occupying the space as well. So let us see how this is going to happen, or how this entire scenario is going to be define this air to be a matter. Okay, we will be performing some of the activities, and with the help of this we will be able to prove this thing. Okay, starting with here, we have, that is the first activity, that is air occupies space and exerts pressure. So here simply the example of a balloon has been taken, which is the most simplest and the easiest activity to show this part, that is air occupies a space. That is, we just have to take a simple balloon, as you can see the girl is doing, and we just have to inflate it. That is, we just have to fill air inside this balloon with the help of our mouth. As a result of this, the size of the balloon increases because air keeps on getting filled inside the balloon. Okay, the moment you stop it, the size of the balloon also stops increasing. And the moment you deflate it, deflate, inflate and deflate, please try to understand the meaning of this thing. Inflation means hawa bharna, deflation means bahar nikalna, hawa bahar nikalna. Okay, inflation means balloon ko fulana, deflation means basically balloon ko pichkana. So basically what is the thing here is you know that the size of the balloon is very, very small, not more than this part. Okay, but the moment you start filling air into it, the size keeps on increasing bigger and bigger, and a moment comes or a situation comes when you do not stop filling the air, the balloon gets burst up. Okay, phat jata hai. Why this is happening? Because the air is not able to get the space to come out. Okay, as the mouth, the opening of the balloon is present in your mouth, so the air is not able to get, not getting the space, as there is no hole present in the balloon, as a result of which this air starts exerting pressure on the walls or on the boundaries of the balloon, and therefore as a result of this the size of the balloon increases. Okay, so this proves us that air occupies space, because you know that whatever the increase in the size of the balloon is there, that is just because of the air which has been filled into it. Okay, so please try to understand this thing, that is, this is the simplest activity to prove that air occupies space. Okay, moving ahead with this part, exerts pressure. Why? Because it is able to increase in its volume. Okay, let us have a quick reading of this. Take a balloon and blow air into it. Does it become bigger? Yes. The air you blew. Let me show. Okay, this part. Take a balloon and blow air into it. Does it become bigger? The air you blew into it needs space, so it inflates the balloon. Also, it pushes against the walls of the balloon to make it grow larger. Now if you release the mouth of the balloon, it collapses. Collapses basically means that it again comes back to its original shape and size. The air inside the balloon escapes, therefore it returns to its original shape. Blow the balloon again, keep blowing it until it bursts. Why does it burst? Because why does the balloon burst? The balloon gets burst because you are continuously filling the air inside the balloon, but air is not able to get a space to come out, and as a result of which it exerts pressure on the walls of the balloon or on the boundaries of the balloon. But a situation comes, a time comes when the walls or the boundaries of the balloon, they are not able to exert, or they are not able to withstand basically. मतलब वो लोग बर्दाश्त नहीं कर पाते हैं, वो लोग रोक नहीं पाते हैं एयर को, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच दे कम्प्लीटली बर्स्ट आउट, एंड दिस प्रूव्स दैट एयर इज एक्सर्टिंग प्रेशर एज वेल. ओके, सो इन दिस वन एक्टिविटी वी आर एबल टू प्रूव टू थिंग्स, दैट इज द फर्स्ट वन, एयर इज ऑक्यूपाइंग स्पेस, एंड द सेकेंड वन, दैट इज एयर इज एक्सर्टिंग pressure into it. Okay, I hope you can do this activity at your homes. Please try to do it, make a short video of 30 seconds to 1 minute, and please try to send it in the query sessions. Okay, and I hope most of you are going to do it. Basically I would request from two main branches, that is your Knowledge Park and Sarayanandan, as very less queries or very less homeworks or demonstrations or anything which have been told to you is being observed from your side. So I request much more participation from these two branches as compared to Durga Kunda and Samnekar. All right, let us start with here. The next activity, that is to show that air has mass as well. Okay. In this case, what we are doing, we are just using a simple hanger. Okay, this hanger has to be very, very light enough. Okay, why? Because you know this thing, that is, since the weight of the hanger is very much more. Okay, so these balloons will not be able to perform, or they will not be able to show the perfect results here. Okay, so basically what we have to do here is, that is, we have to take two balloons, inflate it of the same size, and tie it to both the ends of the hanger. If you can see, this is our hanger. These are the two balloons in which we have filled the air, or we have inflated the balloon, and we have tied it at two corners of the hanger. Next, what we are going to do is, either we will be prickling it up, or just we will be bursting it up by prickling it with the help of a needle, or we will just loosen the knot here so that the air starts escaping. The moment we loosen the knot, either of the left hand side balloon or of the right hand side balloon, we will observe that this balloon or the hanger swings to in a vertical direction. That is, ye hanger jo ekdam seedha tha initial stages mein, wo ab bilkul tedha ho jayega. Aur kis taraf tedha hoga, matlab seesaw ki tarah exactly. Theek hai, jidhar bhari hoga uski taraf jhuk jayega, aur jidhar halka hoga uski taraf uth jayega. So basic concept here is that is this part, okay, the part which is heavier enough, this will go lower down, and the part which becomes lighter enough, okay, it goes upward. So this shows that since it is heavier, so it goes down, that is, it is exerting mass here, or it is exerting force here, and that is why, since it is having mass, that is why it is able to exert some force. Okay, attach one balloon to either side of the hanger. The hanger should be horizontal. Horizontal matlab ekdam seedha. Okay, now prick one balloon with a pin. The hanger tilts towards the other balloon. This shows that the blown up balloon is heavier than the pricked balloon. Therefore, air has mass here. Okay, so in this way, we are able to prove these two concepts. That is, air is occupying mass. First one. Second, air occupies space. That is why it is known as, or it can be classified as, matter. Next, it is also able to exert pressure here. And this, hum atmospheric language mein baat kare, to the pressure exerted by the atmosphere, jaise hamare upar bhi air ka pressure rehta hai, hame pata nahi chalta hai. Okay, so this, because each and every one is surrounded by air only, har jagah air hai, aisa kahin bhi aap nahi keh sakte ho ki wahan pe air nahi present hai. So since each and every place this air is present, as a result of which this air keeps on exerting pressure on our heads as well as on the other body parts, and this pressure which is exerted by the air is known as your atmospheric pressure. Is that clear? Remember, the pressure exerted by the air is known as your atmospheric pressure. Moving ahead with this, okay, this checkpoint, if you can see, give one word answers. I request you to try it by your own, and thereafter we will be going ahead, or we will be discussing it a little later. Now next we have the water. Okay, now what about this water? Let us first describe. If you remember, I have already told you that if anyone asks you what is water, what is carbon dioxide, so you will not start telling directly your answers. That is, water is needed for daily household activities, water is needed for drinking, not like this. Okay, I hope you remember that. Again, I'm going to tell you today, and you will have to speak in the same way. Okay, let me see, let me show you here. Okay. The very first thing which comes into mind is the definition of water. Okay, so how you are going to define is, okay, this water, this is simply the word language, and in this way it is written, H2O. okay, this 2 should be little bit lower, that is somewhere here in a smaller, but I'm not able to do it with this, that is why I'm writing it directly. Okay, so this water which is there, this has to be defined in this way. That is, what is water? So you will say, water is a compound made of hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, so simply you will say that is water is what? Water is a compound made of hydrogen and oxygen. And after this, you are going to say whatever you want to say here. Okay, so this is what? This is the definition of water. I hope all of you would have got how to define water and carbon dioxide or oxygen or anything like that, whichever things are asked to you, and thereafter you'll be going ahead. Starting with the next part here. So this is our second part of the chapter, that is your water. All living organisms on the earth need water to survive. Where does this water come from? Water covers nearly 70% of the earth's surface, as we have already discussed yesterday. However, less than 1% of the total water is in the rivers, lakes, and streams. The remaining water is found as ice and in the oceans. We cannot drink sea water as it is too salty. So the water that is found on the rivers, lake, and streams has to be used by all human beings, animals, and plants. If this water gets polluted and becomes unfit for drinking, we will run out of water. Okay. Now just observe here. These percentages are basically, you will find that the compositions which has been shown you, that is 97% is ocean, 3% is your fresh water, ice 2.2% plus usable form 0.8%. So this is the actual figures, or in some books you will find little bit differentiations also. That is, you will be able to find some more less or more percentages by 1 or 2%. That is, in some books either it will be 95 or 96% or even 98 as well, or it will be some other forms of representations as well. Okay, so the basic idea which it is telling here is, that is, first thing, that is, as all of us we know, that is, this water is covering 70% of the earth's surface, but still we are facing the shortage of water. Hum abhi bhi jante hain ki total surface, theek hai, matlab 100% agar hai, maan lijiye total hamara earth ka surface, usse 70% hamara kya hai, water se hi bhara hua hai. To bacha 30%, theek hai, 30%, out of this 30%, 30% may be kya hai, theek hai, kuch mountains hai, kuch hai, आपके लैंड फॉर्म्स हैं, ठीक है, बहुत सारे हैं, जंगल्स हैं और हाउस होल्ड्स हैं, ठीक है, हाउसेस हैं, होम्स हैं, ठीक है, बहुत सारी चीज़ें हैं, ठीक है, बट स्टिल वी आर एबल टू कवर जस्ट आई होप 4 to 5% या 10% के अराउंड है जो हम लोगों ने कैप्चर किया हुआ है, ठीक है. ये अब सोचिए 4 to 5% या 10 to 12% भी कितना ज़्यादा है, बिकॉज वेयर एवर यू गो यू आर एबल टू फाइंड द होम्स एंड द पीपल्स. ऐसा कोई भी जगह बचा नहीं है जहाँ पे आप जाओ और वहाँ पे आपको आदमी न मिले या घर न मिले, ठीक है. आप किसी भी जगह जाइए, आपको दोनों चीज़ें मिल जाएंगी. ओके, सो द बेसिक कंसेप्ट, ओके, और वट इज़ द मेन थिंग इट इज़ टेलिंग हियर, दैट इज़ माई क्वेश्चन इज, दैट इज स्पाइट ऑफ हैविंग 70% वाटर, वी स्टिल आर फेसिंग शॉर्टेज ऑफ वाटर. इफ़ यू टेक स्पेशली द केसेस ऑफ योर राजस्थान reasons. Okay, what is there in the Rajasthan regions? People used to travel a long distances in order to have very little amount of water or to bring water for their homes. Okay, why? Because water is not present in those regions. So first and the foremost thing is that the distribution of water is not uniform, which is one of the main reasons for the unavailability of water at different regions on the surface of the earth here. Okay, that is, पानी क्या है, हर जगह एक जैसा नहीं प्रेजेंट है. कहीं पे ज़्यादा है, कहीं पे कम है, कहीं पे नहीं है, कहीं पे बहुत ज़्यादा है, ठीक है. तो इसके वजह से क्या रहता है, यूनिफॉर्मिटी नहीं है. कहीं पे ज़्यादा, कहीं पे कम, कहीं पे ज़्यादा, कहीं पे कम, कहीं पे बहुत ज़्यादा, कहीं पे बिल्कुल भी नहीं. तो इसके वजह से क्या है, राजस्थान में बिल्कुल भी नहीं है या बहुत कम है. ओके, सो इन दिस वे दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट रीज़न. सेकेंड रीज़न वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव इज दैट इज़ मोस्ट ऑफ दिस, ठीक है, अगर ये 70% जो वाटर है, तो इस 70% में से अगर इसको हम 100% मान लें, या फिर आप 70% ही मान के चलिए, तो 70% में से 67% और 68% और 66% वाटर आपका अनफिट फॉर ड्रिंकिंग है और अनफिट फॉर यूजिंग इट इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ एक्टिविटीज़, या फिर आपके डेली हाउस होल्ड वर्क्स के लिए जो भी आपको पानी चाहिए, दैट इज नॉट फिट दिस 67 to 68%. तो बचे कितने, 2 से 3% बचे. 2 से 3% में भी क्या है, वो बेसिकली आपके रिवर्स में है, लेक्स में है, ठीक है, जहाँ पॉन्ड्स में है, जहाँ पर आप जाकर के पानी यूज़ नहीं कर सकते हो। बेसिकली इनहैबिटेंट्स जो लोग उनके पास में रहते हैं वही लोग उस पानी का ज़्यादातर यूज़ करते हैं। ओके, तो बचता ये है कि बहुत ही स्मॉल अमाउंट, दैट इज 0.8% या फिर 0.,, आप कुछ भी कह सकते हो, मतलब लेस देन 1% ऑल्सो इज द फ्रेश वाटर विच इज़ अवेलेबल फॉर ड्रिंकिंग एंड कैरिंग आउट आवर वेरियस एक्टिविटीज़। ठीक है, अब ये 1% भी क्या है, धीरे धीरे कम हो रहा है। क्यों कम हो रहा है? बिकॉज ईच एंड एवरी वन, द पॉपुलेशन इज राइजिंग, ईच एंड एवरी वन इज डिगिंग अप द ट्यूबवेल्स, समरसेबल्स, बोरिंग्स एंड एवरीवेयर। ठीक है, क्या है, लोग ज़्यादा हो रहे हैं तो उनके यूजेस भी ज़्यादा हैं, कंजम्पशन ऑफ वाटर ज़्यादा है, कोई भी गंदा पानी तो यूज़ करेगा नहीं, सभी लोग फ्रेश पानी ही यूज़ करेंगे। ओके, सो इन दिस वे वॉट इज हैपनिंग, वाटर इज गेटिंग पोल्यूटेड डे बाई डे, एंड इफ वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू स्टॉप द वेस्टेज ऑफ दिस वाटर। ठीक है, पहले क्या होता था, कुएं में पानी रहता था, कुएं से पानी हम लोग निकालते थे, ठीक है, और कुएं से पानी निकाल के हम लोग क्या करते थे, मतलब पूरा का पूरा गांव उसी कुएं के पानी से काम चलाता था, अपने घर के खाने बनाने से लेकर के पीने तक सब कुछ। ठीक है, लेकिन अब क्या है, हर घर में बोरिंग है, ठीक है, हर घर में समरसेबल्स हैं, हर घर में सप्लाई है वाटर का। ठीक है, इवन योर द सप्लाई वाटर इज ऑल्सो मच गुड, मच बेटर एज कम्पेयर टू इंडिविजुअल बोरिंग्स विच यू हैव इन योर होम्स। ठीक है, प्रॉब्लम्स होती है, सबके साथ होती है, बट स्टिल इफ यू टेक इट फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंटल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू और कंजर्वेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, इन दैट केस ऑल दिस बोरिंग्स और समरसेबल्स दे आर हार्मफुल फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ अस। ओके, स्टार्टिंग विथ दिस, सो बेसिकली क्वेश्चन ये है, और ये बहुत ही मेजर कंसर्न है कि जैसे हमारा एयर पॉल्यूशन के बारे में हम इतने ज़्यादा एनवायरनमेंट को लेकर के कंसर्न है, तो उसी में हमारा एक नेचुरल रिसोर्स वाटर भी है, कि ये 1% या 0.8% जो फ्रेश वाटर है उसको भी हम जिस तरीके से यूज़ कर रहे हैं, एक्सप्लॉयट कर रहे हैं। ठीक है, पहले के लोग क्या करते थे, ठीक है, हैंडपम्प से जब आपको पानी, जब आपको मेहनत करना पड़ता है तो आप कम से कम पानी में मैक्सिमम चीज़ें करना चाहते हो, बट लेकिन जब आपको खाली टैप खोल करके काम करना रहता है तो आप टैप खोल देते हो, काम होता रहता है। ठीक है, सो इन दिस केस अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर इज गेटिंग वेस्टेज। ओके, और आप भी जान रहे हो कि सभी लोग फ्रेश वाटर का ही यूज़ करते हैं, कोई भी गंदा पानी नहीं यूज़ कर रहा है। ओके, सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच आवर दिस 0.8% ऑफ वाटर इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग लोवर्ड डे बाई डे, एंड अ सिचुएशन कैन कम और अ डे कैन कम वेन वी विल बी फेसिंग सम और द अदर इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू दिस। तो वो दिन ना आए उससे अच्छा है कि उसके पहले हम लोग कोई ना कोई कंजर्वेशन स्ट्रेटजी, कंजर्वेशन मेजर्स ले लें, जैसे रूफ टॉप रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग, या फिर कम से कम यू शुड यूज बकेट्स एंड मग्स फॉर कैरिंग आउट आवर वेरियस एक्टिविटीज़ लाइक योर ब्रशिंग, वॉशिंग द क्लोथ्स एंड एवरीथिंग। ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड, लेट अस गो अहेड विद दिस। सो बेसिकली वी एज ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड्स, सॉरी, एज ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड्स दिस वाटर फॉर सर्वाइवल, बिकॉज इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर आवर बॉडी एज वेल, एंड अराउंड 65 to 70% ऑफ द बॉडी इज ऑल्सो फिल्ड विथ वाटर ओनली, और हैविंग वाटर एज वन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स। हाउएवर, ओके, दिस हैज बीन ऑलरेडी डन, सो ओके, वन थिंग आई हैव फॉरगॉटन, सो दिस 67 to 68% ऑफ वाटर विच इज नॉट फिट फॉर आवर ड्रिंकिंग, दैट इज बेसिकली लॉक्ड और फिक्स्ड आइदर इन द पोलर आइस कैप्स वेयर इट हैज बीन गॉट कन्वर्टेड इन टू आइस, वी कैन नॉट यूज इट, एंड द सेकेंड फॉर्म इज दैट इज दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द ओशंस वेयर द वाटर इज कम्प्लीटली सॉल्टी, दैट इज द वाटर इज कंटेनिंग अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्ट इन इट, सो वी कैन नॉट यूज दैट सॉल्टी वाटर। एंड आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर अ स्मॉल स्टोरी, मैंने आपको कई बार उड़ीसा के बारे में चर्चा किया है, पूरी के बारे में चर्चा किया है, ठीक है, जगन्नाथपुरी, सो देयर ऑल्सो आई थिंक ओशंस ही है, सागर ही है वो, ठीक है, महासागर कोई है, तो वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू गो देयर और इफ़ यू टेक अ बाथ इन दैट, सो दैट वाटर इज कम्प्लीटली सॉल्टी देयर। ओके, इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू टेक बाथ फॉर 10 to 15 minutes इन दैट ओशन, ओके, योर बॉडी विल, यू स्टार्ट फीलिंग सम काइंड ऑफ बर्निंग सेंसेशन इन योर आइज, नोज एंड मे बी सम काइंड ऑफ चोकिंग सेंसेशंस इन योर माउथ एज वेल, दैट इज द टंग विल स्टार्ट फीलिंग सॉल्टी बिकॉज सम ऑफ द वाटर एंटर सम हाउ, एंड एट द सेम टाइम योर बॉडी विल स्टार्ट हैविंग सम वाइट कलर्ड पाउडर्ड सब्सटेंसेस, दैट इज नथिंग बट द सॉल्ट So since the water is containing the salt, okay, when you get out of this oceans or you just remain there for some time, so what happens to the water, which is present on your body? It gets evaporated and the salt gets left behind on your body, that which you are able to see in the white form. Okay, so this is how the salt is also extracted. That is, seawater is basically collected. Water is allowed to evaporate, and the salt is left behind, which is again filtered, purified, and packed and transported into the markets or made available to us. Okay. Going ahead with this. Okay, so we have to take care so that it does not get polluted, because otherwise we are going to face a lot of problems with it. Okay. Good. Okay, still we have 2 minutes. Let us go ahead. Let us do this activity, and after that we'll be starting with this properties of water, because we don't have that much time here. Okay, so activity number 5 says that fill half glass of water with water, add a quarter spoonful of mustard seeds into it, mix it with a spoon. The mustard seeds do not disappear. They settle down at the bottom of the glass. They do not dissolve in water. Therefore, we say that mustard seeds are insoluble in water. Okay. So basically, in this, we will be discussing about this in the properties of water. That is, what are the things which are soluble and what are the things which are not soluble. Okay. So all those substances which are soluble, they are known as soluble substances. And the substances which do not get soluble, they are known as your insoluble substances. Okay. No problem. We'll be going ahead with this part in the next class, that is on Monday. I hope Monday is a holiday. Maybe. Let us see. Okay. We have started with this part. Okay. That is your air, water. That is your second natural resource present on the surface of the earth. Very essential natural resource. And each and everyone has to take care. Otherwise, we are going to face a lot of problems with it. Okay. So, starting with this. This was all for today. Okay, please do not forget to have the thorough readings of whatever we are studying, and please try to have the readings from the very beginning, that is the first page where we started, so that if once or twice you are going to have the readings, you will be able to get the doubts. Okay, and I can bet you this thing, or I can just challenge you on this, that is, if you are going to have a thorough reading, you will be able to face some or the other problems. It is not like this that you are perfect enough, okay, or I am perfect enough. Okay, if I am also going to have the readings 3 to 4 times, I will also start facing problems, or one or two words will be there, some new things will be there which has to be understood. Okay, so I request some of your questions, and I hope it would be there in the query sessions as well. Okay. So this was all for today. Thanks a lot for being with me. And please don't forget to take all the necessary precautions, as now we are going to meet after Diwali. Okay, so a very happy Diwali in advance to each and every one of you. And please be careful while using the crackers in a very limited amount, as much as you can. Okay, so till then, take care. And please take all the necessary precautions to protect yourself from the COVID-19 as well as from the crackers. So C for COVID-19, C for crackers, please. Both the things are dangerous. Okay, so please take care of this thing. We'll be meeting ahead in our next class after Diwali celebrations. That's all for today. Please take care of yourself. Thank you, and have a superb day ahead.